Greetings, Eric Backer, naturopath from New Zealand. I'm the author of Candida Crusher and the formulator of the Candida range of products. I'm in sunny Las Vegas at the moment, really enjoying it. Thanks for tuning in. We're going to talk now about enzyme deficiency. What kind of problems can come out from enzyme deficiency? Can it cause symptoms? Can it cause diseases? What can happen? So when we talk about enzymes, because there are thousands of enzymes in the body, I'm going to mainly talk about digestive enzymes, enzymes made in the stomach, by the pancreas, which are produced and then put into the small intestine. This is where really the heart of enzyme activity occurs in the sort of upper and central GI system. So enzyme deficiency is very common, particularly with high stress. I see a lot in males and females. Enzyme deficiency is common with people who live hectic lives, who drink alcohol a lot, who will be eating food and liking people on Facebook kind of thing at the same time. I've been downstairs before having lunch. And when I was having lunch, I sat in this bar. I'm in this sort of resort in Las Vegas. Every single person's on their mobile phone with a glass of wine. And a lot of them are just sitting there eating their meals while they're going, like this. And they're, oh, that person likes me. And let's look at this cat video. And so everyone's on these flaming mobile phones. Those are the sort of things that create enzyme deficiency, right? It's not a good idea. Lack of concentration, right? It's bad. As I say in previous videos, it's like driving a car and texting at the same time. It's not a good idea. You've got to keep your eyes on the road. You've got to keep your eyes on the plate. Those things create big enzyme deficiencies. Enzyme deficiencies lead to lots of problems. Burping. That wasn't a burp, but you know what I mean? Air coming up. So burping, bloating, farting. BBF. Not BLT, BBF. Burping, bloating, farting. Okay? So often it's like a car backfiring. Poor ignition. Have you ever heard a car go bang or a lawnmower exploding or something? This is usually because the spark can't ignite the gas. So poor compression occurs and you can get a backfire. So farting can be a backfire from enzyme deficiency. Burping can be also a symptom of enzyme deficiency, very common. But it could also be bacterial infection. But many, many guys my age, like 50s, 60s, have got many of them. I would say half to three quarters will have a problem with their stomach. They're just not breaking food down properly. The key things I see as a result are tiredness, right? So the car backfiring has got poor performance. It can't drive very fast, can it? It's going to go all over the place. It's not going to have a nice steady acceleration, and taking off. Just like the digestion can't accelerate properly and propel energy into the person. Very similar. So fatigue, tiredness, very common. Sleeping disorders. But many, many digestive problems will occur before, the body will actually start feeling it systemically. So generally the person for months or years will have all these GI kind of symptoms. They'll go to the doctor. Oh yes, I think we've got over-acidity of the stomach. We'll just put you on a PPI drug. We'll put you on Losec, or we'll put you on, omeprazole or some crap like that. So not a good idea. So if you think that you've got like heartburn or, you're burping or reflux, there's a big chance it's in fact exactly the opposite of what the doctor's saying. It's not over-acidity, it's under-acidity, which is an enzyme deficiency, right? So chewing is better pooing. We've talked about that before. Chewing food properly means you're breaking the food down really well. So remember, when you're looking at crazy cat videos, you can't really chew food properly because half the food's going to fall out of your mouth anyway because you're laughing that much. Right? So enzyme deficiencies, when pulled out for many, many years, can give serious health consequences for people, serious health consequences. If you continually have gut problems and starve the cells from proper nutrition because of poor enzymes, I mean, just pick up a Merck manual, a disease manual, and pin the tail on the donkey. You could literally get any kind of disease as a result. If you starve cells long enough, you could get any kind of chronic illness. So folks, I can't emphasize this enough. Please make sure that if you burp, bloat, or fart, that you look at a good digestive enzyme formula, preferably one with a probiotic with it, because that's going to allow the bugs in your gut to thrive on the food that you've chewed properly. Okay, broken down properly and absorbed and assimilated in the cells, and you're going to feel great. So please give it a go. Check out Candida Restore. It's a formula I created is particularly for people like this who've got burping, bloating, farting, and also enzyme deficiencies. Check it out. Thanks for tuning in.